how y'all doing this morning? My name is Matthew Wright. I'm a spiritual teacher and an empathic intuitive psychic and a spirit medium.
My name is Jeremy Elliott. I'm a spiritual teacher as well, psychic medium, clairvoyant.
And, we just wanted to do this video because kept feeling Tahliek, right, coming through from the other side. So he wants to speak. He's got some stuff that he wants to get off his mind, you know. So we're going to let him talk.
Yes. Well, Tahliek is standing in front of me. I would say, you know, he's a light skin colored African American dude. You know, he's a young 17 years old. He was shot. I'm going to tell you, he was shot in the back. Shot in the back, you know, a few times, I believe, more than once. He's upset about the situation with the three boys that were around him.
I think it was a girl too, wasn't it?
May have been.
Yeah.
But he's more upset with the three boys.
Three boys.
Yeah. And he's kind of upset why this happened to him, you know. But he's not mad. Let me say this. He's not mad. He's just, I guess he would like answers himself, you know. That's where I can start.
Well, what do you feel about this stuff, Ben? I mean, you know, you've been around observing what's going on. I mean, what do you think about what this all has turned into?
He's saying it's okay in his life where he is now, you know.
Okay.
Everything's okay. Like this. I'm okay.
Yeah.
You know, he's saying it's them that's not okay. he's real hung up on that, you know.
That's what I kind of felt.
Yeah. He's like, in this world, I'm okay, you know, but in this world, you know, he wasn't, you know. His world, our world, I mean.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He keeps getting drawn here from the situation, the thoughts, and yeah, I know you are.
Yeah, he doesn't know exactly what happened. Yeah,
I mean, look,
he does.
But yeah, you do know what happened,
yeah.
But you know, but why do you say you're confused though? That's what I'm not getting. You know.
Well, because when he left his body, it wasn't like he was prepared to leave his body.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? That's what I'm saying. He's just. Zooted out.
Yeah.
So he had a lot of unfinished business that he felt like he could attend to. Not that he's not all right, though.
Yeah, believe me, he's all right. I mean,
yeah.
He's in a pretty good place, more than good.
So. Oh, yeah, I'm all right.
Yeah, he's fine. He's you're worried about the situation left here, right?
Right, anything left behind. Even the guilt amongst people's minds that did what they did to him.
Yeah.
You know, they're not all right. You know, those people aren't all right.
That's what I'm feeling with them. Remember I said last night, you know, that they have that guilt within. I kind of felt that too, man. Like that they have pain too, suffering.
Yeah.
I mean, I know it's hard to hear for y'all to hear what some of the stuff we're talking about, but I mean, people die and stuff, like they get concerned. They're happy where they are, but they get concerned for the aftermath, you know?
Yeah, because he's saying, I'm all right, like in a way that he's got the nice chair. And everything he wants, you know, he's cool, he's all right.
Oh, yeah,
yeah. You know, I guess he's just there's a lot of, he knows it's a lot of emotional backdraft that he didn't get to be involved in, you know what I'm saying? That's what I'm seeing from him.
But
he's smiling.
Yeah, I know you're happy, man. Yeah. I can feel that laid backness in you, brother. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and I mean, but what do you want, like, come out, like, but didn't you say you kind of wanted to talk to your mom and let her know you're all right? I know you're doing it now, but, I mean, you know, whatever you want to say, man. I know you got things that I'm not going to think of, but come out and say what's on your mind.
He wants to say hi to his family, you know, all his moms, his brothers, sisters, all around town, you know. He said he wants to, he feels like he's back, you know. This is his opportunity to talk, though. He's okay. Whoever's mourning over him right now, which there is somebody mourning over him right now.
Mom, isn't it?
And he's saying he's okay. Yeah, you know, I just see that there is. He has a list.
There's a whole list of people. It's not just your mom is there with it, but there's other people.
Yeah, there's
other people. I see.
But they just worrying about death, you know, not the the fact that he's okay or not, you know. He's okay. So the death thing is kind of balanced out at that point, you know. He's a good guy, you know. He just had mixed in with the wrong people sometimes. Yeah. He was the kind of son that would come home and do chores, you know, around the house and stuff, and help out the best he could when he had his evenings. He was out in the evenings. That's when he was shot.
In the evening?
Yeah. Yeah. That's when they played, as he would say.
Played?
Yeah.
Out there just chilling. I can see him riding around and whatnot, just living out in the country. I guess people ride and stuff more and just drive place to place and
just running around. Yeah, I can see him being outside a car, doing like, you know, running back into each other's cars and stuff. You know, I see all this city and the, you know, mentality. You know what I'm saying? It's a city mentality where people used to get in their, you know, they used to run out in their cars and do their Chinese doorbell and all that, whatever it was.
Yeah.
They'd go through the car. I don't remember what it was. But they would be doing stuff like that, you know, out there in the country, you know what I'm saying? Just getting out and partying and hanging out. So
basically, like, I mean, I just feel this whole thing here is just beef gone overboard, you know?
Yeah.
And people trying to be hard and all of this stuff and trying to act hard. That's what it comes down to, you know?
Yeah, the Lord Buddha appeared.
All right.
Yeah. I just wanted to say that, you know.
We have a Buddha helps us out in a lot of these things we do. The Buddha says that's for Buddha.
Lord Buddha says, you know, it's a lot to do with letting go of all things, you know, to get past his situation and his family situation. You see what I mean? To get past this, they must let go. They must let go of his disappointment. They must let go of their grieving, so forth and so on, and their pain. Whoever's feeling anything, they should let go. You see what I mean? Mm-hmm. I'm trying to interpret what the Buddha said, but all he said was, it's time to let go of what you have here and there, you know?
Let go of the agony, the grief, and the anger. I feel anger especially. Let go of that anger. You know, as hard as it is to hear that, you do need to do it.
It's not going to change anything, you know?
Nothing will change. And none of it. You can be angry the rest of your life and about what happened, and it's just going to tear you up.
Yeah, you know? It does tear you inside out, you know? And you can just change the channel, kind of, in a sense, and move on, you know? You have to.
Because you're just going to get, like I said, eaten up. It's like a monster. Anger and grief is like a snake or something, or a monster following you. And it just keeps nipping at you, nipping parts of you out of you.
We know you're okay, man. We're not trying to say, what he's doing.
We know you're all right, man. I mean, this is what we're trying to get across to
them. But let me say this. That's what makes me seem to think that he's got some things he hasn't dealt with, you know. But it's
That's what the Buddha said about him.
Yeah, he's got, exactly. See,
you heard what Lord Buddha said, Tahliek, and I say,
just trust the Lord Buddha if you don't trust me, you know.
Yeah, because, well, you know, I mean, Buddha is very, you know, you'll see, you know. Lord Buddha, help, you know, keep helping him, please, you know, help him out, you know.
He's got to just, he's got to be passive, you know.
Yeah.
That's all I'm seeing.
Just gotta be passive, man. Because look, you keep saying you're okay, League, man.